Welcome to the Microsoft Virtual Academy. Thanks for joining us today. This session we will cover the Orchestrator architecture with System Center 2012 SP1 Orchestrator. My name is Andreas Reins. I'm a data center architect in the worldwide data center private cloud center of excellence. And I'm covering today the architecture of our Orchestrator 2012 version. And what are actually the objectives for today? First of all, I would like to describe all the components of Orchestrator architecture. And then we are going a little bit more into the details about the functionality of those components within an Orchestrator infrastructure. So here is the agenda for this session. First of all, I'd like to introduce you to Orchestrator. Then I will cover a couple of customer scenarios, how customers are using Orchestrator in production environments. Then we are going to cover Orchestrator and the System Center integration. So how does Orchestrator works together with all the other System Center components? Then we will handle a little bit of the terms about Orchestrator, the terminology. So that's the overall agenda for this session for the next 20 minutes. So first of all, I would like to give you a very short introduction to Orchestrator, what it is. Actually, Orchestrator gives you or provides you an environment for process automation. So this is also known as a runbook automation, and the overall goal is to give you the ability to orchestrate and integrate IT management tools through those runbooks. So automation can reduce costs and also simplify the management and optimize resources. With System Center Orchestrator, you will get multi-vendor integration, so you're not locked in a specific vendor. You can really work across your systems, your platforms, and your tools you're going to use today. There are a couple of pre-built activities and workflow processes already there, so that will speed up the time to make that happen. And it will also replace manual tasks and activities you have to do all day long in your data centers today. And without any coding or scripting, you're able to really build workflows and configure those workflows and run them. So you don't have to code anything, depending on your requirements, of course. And what I said before, it really spans about multiple IT components, disciplines, and silos. So it brings all those stuff together that you are having in your data centers today. So what are actually the capabilities of Orchestrator? So it's a workflow management solution for your data center to really automate your processes, and regardless of your hardware and your platform and the tools you're going to use. And it really brings together those disparate tasks with one graphical user interface, which is called the Runbook Designer, but we will cover that in a moment. And you have really one front-end, one designer, where you build your workflows across all your systems and tools. And it really enables you to really have those end-to-end solutions that are flexible and efficient and really easy to design and build. So when I talked about cross-platform, what does that mean? So first of all, of course, we have a very deep integration with all the other System Center components, like operations manager, service manager, and the others. And you also have integration with other Microsoft products like Active Directory and SQL Server, as well as integration with non-Microsoft products. So there is a bunch of integration packs available that gives you the ability to not only talk to Microsoft products, but also to talk to non-Microsoft products and to involve those products in your workflows in the data center. So it enables interoperability, and it really improves the efficiency of your daily job in the data center. So you can eliminating those structures between different organizations as well as technology. And with the integration packs that I've mentioned before, you're really extending the capabilities of Orchestrator. So Orchestrator comes with a set of basic functionality and activities that are there out of the box. And with those integration packs, no matter if they are for Microsoft products or non-Microsoft products, you're able to extend that capabilities and import additional functionality to System Center Orchestrator. So, as mentioned before, I would also like to cover a little bit about how customers are using Orchestrator today. Those three examples you're going to see here are just really three out of many. First of all, incident management. So Orchestrator really helps you to bring your incident management and resolution together. It helps you to automate tasks that you want to involve in your incident management, and it really integrates across all the disciplines that are used with that incident management. So, for example, service tasks with your CMDB, with monitoring tools and stuff like that. So, those are the main two products that will that Orchestrator brings together: Service Manager and Operations Manager. The second one is virtual machine lifecycle management. When you think of how to provision virtual machines, how do you do your allocations, and how you do your deprovisioning, you're really able to use Orchestrator to help you in automating those processes. From the very beginning of a virtual machine up to the end, where it will be deprovisioned again. And last but not least, Service Manager, the CMDB automation. So think about your configuration items to the updates you want to drive within your CMDB, about new relationships between those objects within the CMDB, and Orchestrator can really help you to drive that and to automate those tasks and really work across Service Manager, Configuration Manager, as well as maybe an already existing ticketing system in your data center. So if we talk about Orchestrator, which is actually one component of the System Center 2012 suite, we have to talk a little bit about the capabilities and components. So those three pillars that you see here are the main pillars and main capabilities of System Center 2012. First of all, it's application management. Application management really empowers you to really deliver predictable applications as services to your business counterparts. And it really offers the application owners to have a single view and to manage their application services across traditional data center, across private and public clouds. And, of course, it also extends the way how to monitoring those applications, no matter where they live, if they live in a public cloud like on Windows Azure, or if they live within your data center. That's actually Application Monitor, one of the three pillars within System Center 2012. The second one is Service Delivery and Automation. With System Center 2012, you are able to really automate core organizational process workflows, for example, incident management, which we covered the slide before, problem management, change management, and also release management. And you can also integrate and extend your existing tool sets and build flexible workflows to automate processes really across your IT assets and organization. And one way to do that is using System Center 2012 Orchestrator and, of course, Service Manager as the foundation for your CMDB. Last but not least, it's infrastructure management. And within infrastructure management, this is kind of interesting. System Center 2012 provides you really one common management toolset, and you're able to monitor and operate your IT infrastructure. And it doesn't really matter if that's your physical hardware, your virtual resources like virtual machines, if it's public or private cloud, you have one single set of tools to manage all those different type of resources. So to go a little bit into more detail what application management means, with that figure that you see on your screen right now, this represents a three-tier service with a front end, with a middle tier and the back end, and that's associated with virtual infrastructure that hosts those components. And System Center 2012 offers a really a service-centric approach to help you manage your application components, really in a context of a holistic business service. So it utilizes service templates to define standardized application blueprints for your private cloud. So you're defining a service template that consists of a couple of different tiers like the one you see on your screen right now. And you typically include specification for the hardware, for operating system and application packages. And then you're going to compose that service. And there are multiple packages types available within service templates. So for Microsoft.NET applications, including MS Deploy for web tier, server application virtualization, server app V for application tier, and SQL Server DAC for data tier. So, and this really, this service template specify application configuration requirements like topology, elasticity, scale out rules, health thresholds, upgrade rules, and stuff like that. So, and you're then, by providing that service template, your consumer, your application owner is able to create an instance of that application with a couple of clicks with their portal. So that's all about application management. So last but not least, let's go into the infrastructure management. And here we have System Center 2012 providing you really a common management toolset to help you to configure, provision, monitor, and operate your IT infrastructure. And if your infrastructure is like that of most organizations, you have physical and virtual resources running really different operating system, and you want to manage them all. With System Center 2012, you're able to deploy and configure virtual servers like Hyper-V with Virtual Machine Manager, but you're also able to manage third-party hypervisors like VMware and Xen Server with one interface. And you're also able to deploy Hyper-V to bare metal servers and create Hyper-V clusters, and also really do patching for your infrastructure. So this is more or less the deployment stuff of your infrastructure, but you also want to operate your infrastructure, and you have really one single console and customizable dashboards in Operation Manager to really monitor and manage your physical, virtual, network, application, and cloud resources, all in one common set of tools like that you have in System Center 2012. You have the opportunity to optimize your virtual resources for load balancing on power to get more power efficiency. You are able to use endpoint protection and data protection manager to protect your physical and virtual resources, and you are also able to automatically patch your physical and virtual resources using Configuration Manager and Virtual Machine Manager automatically. And you're also able to track and create custom reports for hardware inventory, software inventory, and software usage metering. So that's all part of the infrastructure management pillar of System Center 2012. So with that overview about System Center 2012, let's go more into detail of Orchestrator, one component of System Center 2012. And to get into more of the details of Orchestrator, I would like to cover a couple of terms that you will hear all the time, not only in this session, but also in the upcoming session. One of that is the management server. Actually, the management server of Orchestrator is the layer, the communication layer between the runbook designer, the tool you're going to use to design your runbooks, you're designing the workflows there, and the orchestration database. Actually, the orchestration database is one SQL Server database where all the runbooks are hosted and stored. So the management server really enables you to communicate between the designer and the database. The runbook server, and you see on the right there might be a couple of runbook servers, not only one instance of that. The runbook server is responsible to run all instances of your runbooks. So, and the runbook servers communicate directly with the orchestration database. And what I said already, multiple runbook servers per orchestrator installation are possible to increase capacity and redundancy. Couple of more terms. Activity. Actually, activity is a single task in a runbook that performs a specific function. One example you see on the screen is create user. That's a single activity that will create a user in Active Directory, and we will cover that in a little bit more detail in a second. The data bus, also a very rich mechanism in Orchestrator that allows you to pass this information from one activity in a runbook to another activity. So you're able to consume the output of one activity in the next activity by using the data bus in Orchestrator. And to do that, each activity has to publish data to the data bus. And that will happen automatically for the activities in the integration packs that are available and that part of Orchestrator itself. But you're also able to publish your own data to that data bus by using published data. So, couple of more terms here. Database. Actually, that database contains all deployed runbooks and also the status of running runbooks. So you're able to see which runbooks are running and what is the status of those runbooks. And of course, it keeps all the configuration data and the log files of Orchestrator in that database. The runbook itself, that's the workflow. It's a sequence of activities that orchestrate actions on computers and networks across tools, across systems, across organizations, and that's a runbook that really hosts the complete workflow. And the runbook designer, that's the tool you're going to use to build and to manage your Orchestrator runbooks. And we'll see that in the next session where we are going into more into the details of the interfaces that are available with Orchestrator.